from the beginning till the end. And a novel of the 80s, The Children of the Midnight Children. With that, we come to the end of this. You read this portion carefully, and I hope you will be able to get into the heart of this wonderful novel. You must always remember that two important things are very important. I mean, worth remember: vision and craftsmanship. What kind of vision has driven Salman Rushdie to make such a bold experimentation? Number one. Number two. What are the elements of his craftsmanship to save a novel, or the shaping forces in the novel used by Salman Rushdie, which make it absolutely new, fresh, bold, adventurous? So this adventure in the field of fiction writing, novel writing, has to be appreciated in proper light, ladies and gentlemen. And now we have to short story volume, I mean, six. What is short story? As the title suggests, it is a short story, the canvas, obviously. The canvas of a story is bound to differ from that of a novel. There you had plot, character, setting, point of view. Here also you have plot, character, setting, and point of view. But the scale is small, it's not wide. And that is always a challenge. A successful short story, it is difficult to write a successful short story because it doesn't allow the writer much space while talking about characters, while introducing various turns and twists in the plot, while making use of a setting or locale, L-O-C-A-L-E, locale or backdrop, or while presenting a point of view. It may be working the writer's point of view on the standard point of view, or it may be the point of view of the character. So similar things happen in both the genres, the novel or short story. This is the fundamental. So I would once again request you to go to the book of Rees or Hassel. Either Rees or Hassel. Rees, Forms of Literature, or Introduction to the Study of Literature by Hassel. The six fundamentals. So the basic elements of short story: page 9, page 10, plot, narration, and then atmosphere. Atmosphere establishes lifelikeness and wins the reader's willingness. To emphasize the element of verisimilitude, similarity with life situations. Okay. The atmosphere is another important thing. Well, atmosphere is also there in a novel. Here they have especially pointed out plot, characterization, atmosphere, then narrative techniques. It may be narrative technique, maybe the first person narration for intimacy and immediacy. Page 11, 1.3.4, narrative techniques. This is an important portion. You must not lose sight of. So first person narration for intimacy or immediacy. And number two, third person narration gives the author the freedom of movement. The freedom of movement, as you found in case of Untouchable or Kanthapura. Famous like that. First person narration or third person narration in a novel. Then there are other elements like credibility, trick ending element, by introducing an element of sense and surprise, and all that. Then figurative language. They are using words to convey what they do is beyond the literal meaning. That is what is generally called figurative language: similes, metaphors, paradoxes, antitheses, fury, euphemism, hyperbole, eulogy, understatement, several speech. I mean, patterns of language we have deliberately by the convincing. 1.3.6. And if you apply in the point of view, the angle of theater, as in the novel, here too, point of view provides an angle of theater, point of view, writer's point of view, the omniscient narrator, that is the writer of point of view, or the character's point of view. So different points of view enlarge our vision, help us gain new perspective. Whether it is that of a character who is introducing himself in first person, or that of the author who adopts the technique of once upon a time. Once upon a time, there was a king kind of thing. So these things actually, these points of view are maintained very carefully to unify the story, to achieve top structure, and to convincingly present to the reader the writer's perspective, the author's perspective, the author's vision. So point of view has something to do with the ultimate vision of the writer, which drives him to choose a particular theme or a particular character and write a short story. Okay. There is a glossary. Page 13, 14, 15. Look at, ladies and gentlemen, there is a glossary which you must consult. This glossary will help you. And while talking about this, I would like to suggest another book, Lee T. Lemon. Lee T. Lemon. Lemon, you know. Lee, L-E-E, Lee, stop, T, stop, Lemon. Lee T. Lemon is actually a book of literary terms. That book is going to help you. That might be available in the library. So you can go through this glossary of terms, which will help you understand the various techniques. Then you have R.K. Narayan, the master storyteller from India, in the pre and the post independence. You have already known something about this great person, Narayan, Mulkaraj Anand, and Raja Rao. R.K. Narayan's two stories have been prescribed for you. One is The Astrologer's Day, and another is Engine Trouble. The master storyteller who makes use of the comic and the tragic very masterfully. That is the greatness of Narayan. He is a very realistic writer who makes use of the comic element to sustain the interest of the reader. And his choice is absolutely upbeat. Very unusual characters and unusual situations he chooses for his short stories. So R.K. Narayan, who died some time back, has enriched the repertory of Indian English fiction. And there is no comparison. He is considered second only to Tagore, the second greatest Indian writer. One of the greatest Indian writers, second only to Rabindranath Tagore. His contribution, An Astrologer's Day, very funny story, very interesting story. Some critics find that it is not very convincing. The storyline is not very convincing. But then, it is a kind of an experiment he does. He brings in an astrologer, the murderer, and another character who has been murdered, who is supposed to be murdered. Okay, the two characters have been presented from a very mysterious angle. So mystery and suspense are there. The astrologer leaves his village, goes to the township, collects certain raw materials necessary to pose as an astrologer, and sits on the pavement to attract the people, earn some money. He knows nothing of astrology, but but he makes use of strong common sense, very very shrewd kind of character, who is capable of strong common sense, and making use of strong common sense, he starts his business and earn money. And it so happens that one evening, while he is getting to close his shop by the side of the pavement, a gentleman comes, looks worried, insists on the astrologer to tell him something about the future, about his own future, about particularly about the crisis he was in. Astrologer is very happy that even in the dying hours of the day, he has come and he is here also extracting money. And this man, because of the very little light, the side stops, very little light. But the gentleman likes this suit. Lighting it too. He is a elastic. And is able to see the face of this man. And they call it to murder the man. Supposing that he was murdered, the astrologer left the village in half and has come down to the city and disguised himself as an astrologer with a turban and the mark of SS and a veil on his forehead. So you can see that in the light, the handle of the lighter, he can place a spot his enemy. But the man, his supposed enemy, he is not able to recognize it at all. Even so if his enemy is going to do him any harm, so is him don't God that the astrologer is surprised. Sorry, the customer is surprised that the astrologer knows his name. What a powerful statement. So never suspecting that who was goes back with the hope that he will have to do what the astrologer has advised him to do. And that night, the astrologer did a sigh of relief while taking dinner. He confided to his wife that very intelligently and very astute, he has been able to eliminate all of his enemies, silent for the entire lifetime. When the engine travels, as I said, an engine through lottery in a public fair, village fair. Once you win many things, but when the engine has a prize, your life is usually the Ryan has to use. How our social machinery is not actually geared to help people in the right moment. So there is a outside comedy or humor. So the talkative man lot of this which is that you stay to the ball. However, all of us, there is an earthquake. Disaster, natural disaster. And as it happened, the earthquake, the engine, see another place where there is a well, and the engine is the well to the lift. Who is the owner, who is the supposed owner of this engine, believe that earthquake has nothing at all. One very good thing for him, shifting the from the roadside to the master well, where he fits in a cock. Yes, it was here in water.